Today on TOKKANTE, we're looking at six watches up to and around $5,000 that will either maintain their value or increase in value. First, I'll say a few words about investment and watches in general. Second, about what we mean about investment watches up to $5,000. And third, we'll go through a list of six watches that I think will maintain or increase in value. Hi everyone and welcome, I'm Ben. So first I want to say a few words about investment and watches. Watches are not a good investment as a general rule of thumb. It is unhealthy to be in this hobby if the sole purpose is for investment. Recently I saw a guy on Instagram who said he was getting into watches and he just purchased a ceramic Daytona, steel Daytona for around $20,000. And he was asking people whether he should flip it now or he should keep it, if he should sell it later, whether it was going to increase in prices, how long he should keep it to make money off of it. It seems like he was not interested in the watch at all, but only whether he was going to make money off of it. And, you know, if this is the reason why he was getting into watches, I'm saying to him, you know, get out now. I think flippers are bad for the hobby. And great dealers are also bad, but that's for another video. So, but we can't deny that some watches are a very good investment, namely specific models of specific brands. You know, steel sports watches from Rolex, or, you know, Patek Philippe Nautiluses, or, you know, Omega Speedmaster Snoopy 2, or an Omega, an Audemars Piguet, you know, Royal Oak Jumbo 15202. Those watches are a very good investment, we can't deny that. But anyway, they are all well above the $5,000 budget that we're talking about here. So what do we mean by, you know, good investment for watches up to around $5,000? Well, first I want to specify that this is not the same thing as a list of the best watches up to $5,000, or not even a list of, you know, the best bang for the buck watches up to $5,000. For this type of budget, you know, don't expect to double or triple the value of your watches. You have to be reasonable. So when we talk about good investment for 5,000, I think you should have three objectives. Number one is, you know, don't lose any value. Number two, maybe the watch will increase a little bit in value. And number three, if you're lucky, the watch might go up a lot in value, and that's good for you. The goal should be the resale value. And you should not be losing any money if you decide to pass on the watch to someone else and maybe get into something a little more expensive down the road. So now let's look at the list of six watches that I think are good investment for up to $5,000. So how did I select them? Well, obviously it's not easy to find, but that's part of the fun, right? It's the hunt for the perfect watch. And I think under 5K, there's actually a lot of value if you know how to find it. So how do I find it? Well, you can go to websites such as Chrono 24 or Watch Charts or Watch Recon, and you look at historical value charts, or you look at historical sales data, and you look overall over the past few years how the watch has been performing and how it is likely to perform in the future. So for example, on Chrono 24, you can create a free account and have the historical data for the past 5 years. On watch charts, you'll have data for the past 6 months only. If you want to get up to 5 years, you'll have to upgrade and have a premium account. And on Watch Recon, you look at private seller actual sales price, completed sales, and you see for how much the watch actually sell. Now I'll have links to all these websites in the description below. So first we start with Omega, and then the first watch is the Omega Speedmaster, first Omega in space. I've talked a lot about this watch already in previous episodes. It was made from 2012 to 2020. It was recently discontinued at the end of last year. And since then, in the last 3 months, this watch has actually increased in price quite a bit. So I'm not going to spend too much time on it. You can watch one of my other videos, and I've made a review of this watch and why you should get it now. But this is a watch that you might have to look for a little bit to get it at 5K. If you are lucky enough, let's say, and if you buy it from a private seller, you might still be able to get it at 5K, and I think that's a very good buy at this price, because in the next few years I think we might be able to double the value of that watch if you bought it smartly. The second one, staying with Omega, is the Omega Speedmaster Reduced. Now, that model was made from 1988 to 2009. So it was made for a long time, and there are many, many examples of it, probably, you know, tens of thousands. It is slightly smaller than the standard Omega Speedmaster Professional at 39 millimeter. It was meant to be more approachable than the regular Speedmaster. It's an automatic, it has an ETA movement with a Dubois de Praz module on top of it. And this is, funnily enough, this is a Speedmaster that wasn't too popular up until recently. But now we see the price is actually going up. And especially the model made from 2006 to 2009 with a sapphire crystal has been increasing quite a bit if you look at the chart. And you can still find it for around $3,000 US. And if you buy it at that price, I think this is a good buy, especially with the increasing popularity and the resurgence in popularity. So I think you should be safe in down the road. If you want to resell it, you won't be losing any money on this model. Now moving on to Tudor. And now I'm not talking about the Tudor Black Bay 58, because ironically, the value of this watch after the hype has died down a little bit is slightly going down. No, I'm talking about the Tudor Prince Oyster Date Big Block, the 79180 and the 79160, a model that was made between 1976 and 1995. And at the time, it was actually considered in a way better than the Rolex Daytona because it had an automatic movement. The Daytona had something like the Valjoux 72, I believe, whereas the Tudor had an automatic version of ETA in it that made it a lot thicker, and which is why the nickname the Big Block came from. This is a model that might be a little difficult to find at around 5k, but if you look hard enough, it is possible. I know someone who recently bought one with full set box and paper for just above 5k, and the popularity of this model also is increasing faster and faster, so I think that's a very good investment for Tudor. Staying with Tudor, and our fourth watch is a Tudor Black Bay, but not the current one, is the 79220N. It's the original Black Bay that came out in 2012 and discontinued in 2016. But the one, the black one, it came out in red and blue. The black one was only made for about 6 months. And that specific model with the black dial and the black bezel is highly collectible now. The value is going up quite quickly. You can still find it for maybe around $4,000, $4,500, but I think, you know, later down the road, this is a model that will be highly sought after. The original Black Bay is truer to the historical heritage of Tudor. It had the rose on the dial instead of the shield that came later with the in-house movement one. It had the smiley face as well, and it had an ETA movement in it, which, you know, If you look at Tudor's history, this is a brand that was using ETA movement from the beginning. So for collectors, this is actually truer to the original, and this is a model that you should invest in now while you still can under 5K. Now let's talk about the big one, Rolex. Is it possible to find an investment Rolex under 5K? Well, up until recently, you could actually find Rolex Explorer 2 under 5K. It was the underdog of Rolex steel sports watches, and you could still find them quite easily. But what I've been noticing is that prices are going up and up and up, and now it's pretty much impossible to find a good example of an Explorer 2 up or around 5K. Now, where do you go from there? You could find, you know, maybe many Datejusts under 5K, but it's going to be, you know, very small model, 32, 34, or they're going to be very dated, the two tones, you know, plenty of those, but that's not really what you want to look at. So where do we look for, you know, a sports steel Rolex model under 5K that's investment worthy? Well, you look at the Thunderbird. Now, the Rolex Thunderbird, the 16264 especially, with a black or blue dial and stick dial, is an homage to the original Thunderbird that was given a standard issue to the Thunderbird squadron of the US Air Force. And in a way, it was the first pilot watch because it came out before the GMT, and it was the first Rolex sports model with a, well, kind of dressy sports model with a rotating bezel. Now, it might be a little difficult to find a good example of a Thunderbird at around 5K, especially if you want full set with box and papers. But if you look hard enough, That's the fun, right? If you look hard enough and you look at, especially at private sellers, you might still be able to find one. And I think this is a model that down the road, the collectors will look fondly at, and you will never lose basically on it. Now that's five watches already, but we have six watches on the list. Why? Well, because I couldn't end the list without a German watch, obviously. So the sixth one is the Sinn 140 or 142 Space Chronograph. The vintage one specifically with the Lemania 5100 movement in it with the center second. Why? Well, this watch is one of the, you know, legendary space chronograph. It was worn in 1985 by astronaut Reinhard Fuhrer, and it was thought at the time to be the first automatic chronograph in space. Sinn said it was a 140S, but there are actually questions about that, and we're not quite sure whether it was a 140, possibly a 141, or maybe even a 142. It is not proven. But the fact is that it wasn't the first one. In 2007, it came to light that Commander William Pogue had worn 11 years prior to Reinhard Fuhrer, a non-standard issue, his personal Seiko 6139. It was an automatic chronograph. But regardless of that, the 140, 142, actually, his popularity and collectability never wavered. And actually, Sinn rode that wave. And for a long time in the catalog, in the back of the watch, it said the first automatic chronograph in space. And only recently they changed that, and I think now it says, you know, the space chronograph or the chronograph in space. So you can still find those for around maybe $3,500 to $4,000, and they are not making any more of them. So this is a very collectible Sinn. So there we have it. For up to $5,000, we can get quite good pieces actually if we look for them. You know, we start with a Speedmaster first Omega in space. A Speedmaster reduced with a sapphire crystal, an original Black Bay, or a Big Block, or a Rolex Thunderbird, or even a Sinn 140, 142. You know, did you ever consider any of these watches? What would you get under $5,000 that you think will either maintain or increase in value? Let me know in the comments below. Tell me if you found, you know, a jewel for 5K that I never considered. And if you like this type of content, you know, please consider subscribing, sharing, click like on the video, notification bell so you are notified of a new video dropping every Friday. And remember to always ask yourself, you know, what makes you tick? Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.